Faster. Faster sounds always good. What's up, everyone? I'm Neat, and I talk about editing and different visual content creation tips. Subscribe if you're into that stuff. I do weekly videos, and today I'm gonna give you some color grading tips that will help you edit faster and be more efficient. Let's get it. First of all, you need to have a workflow. You need to know where in your editing process you will do your color adjustments, which is your color correction and your color grading. For me, it depends on the project. When I do these talking heads for my YouTube videos, I start color correcting and color grading before I even edit and cut the main video. And that's because I'm shooting in a controlled environment. I mean, the lights, the sound, everything is set up so that I can create a video as efficient as possible. So when I import the video on the timeline, I color correct and then add a simple look. And then I uncheck the effects box right here in the video inspector. And that actually helps lighten the workload on the computer. And then I start cutting, trimming, and edit the main timeline. Now, whatever I do to this video, all these cuts will have the same consistent look. And then at the end, when I finish the edit, I just click here to bring all the color adjustments back. But when I work on a different project, like a sequence shot with different lighting setup or different cameras, I found it more efficient to do the color adjustments at the end instead of at the beginning. After I finish creating the sequence on the timeline, adding all the effects, the audio, the speed ramps, and all that stuff, I color correct. I work on the white balance, exposure, and then I match the shots as much as possible so that I can have a cohesive sequence. I highly recommend to use one adjustment tool per step. This will help you have complete control of any changes you make on the footage. For example, if you're not using any special plugin, you can use the color wheels adjustment to work on the white balance, and then use another color wheels adjustment for the exposure, and another one for contrast, and another one for saturation, and so on and so forth. If you try to do all those color correcting steps in one color wheels or one curves adjustment or other tools in Final Cut Pro, it's gonna be hard to fine tune one adjustment without affecting the other. When you do it one by one, step by step, one adjustment per step, you can adjust the saturation without affecting the exposure and vice versa. And of course, you can do those fine tuning independently with the mix slider right here. So you can increase and decrease the intensity of the changes or the adjustments that you're doing. And the goal is to have more control with every step, every changes, every adjustment, color adjustment you do on your footage. Now, to make this process faster, you can save all the steps you're going to do by clicking right here. But before that, make sure you know how many steps or independent adjustments you're going to do or you're going to use. For me, I know that I need one for white balance, one for exposure, one for contrast, and one for saturation. Those are my steps for color correction. And I like to use the color wheels adjustment for all of them, except maybe for contrast. I like to use a curves adjustment for that. Then I add a color grade at the end. So in total, with no plugin, I usually use three color wheels and one curves adjustment. I click on Save Effects Preset and call it Color Correction Workflow. And now I can just go to Effects and then apply to the footage or the adjustment layer and then start the color correction process. I might add a LUT or add another color wheels or a curve adjustment to create that look at the end, but that's it. If you guys got any value from this video, subscribe and go check out these tips on color grading, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.